Hey there, this is Patrick Evans-Hilton. I am with Dwayne Appleton of JavaSurf, and you are watching another Cuisine Scene video. So now, Dwayne, what are you doing there?
I'm making you a perfect latte, Patrick.
Ah, perfect latte, awesome. So we are in JavaSurf, and you have three locations, two in Virginia Beach and one in Norfolk. Now, how long have you owned JavaSurf?
My wife and I were just talking about that at dinner the other night.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not sure. I have to ask my wife.
A couple of years at least, though, right?
Yeah, I believe 2011 or 2012.
Ah, okay. Oh, look at that. How
pretty. And we used to be on 25th Street and
yes.
Pacific Avenue, right near the Pacific Plaza, a little shopping center over there. It's a heritage spot for Virginia Beach.
Mm-hmm.
There's been coffee shops there for 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really awesome to be able to start there in a really recognizable Virginia Beach locals, space and really humble roots. You know,
yes.
It's only 1,000 square feet. We had a dining room that even when I maxed out the seating, it only sat about 22 seats, which is not very big. And we really stayed open those first couple years just by, taking care of every single customer and paying attention to the quality of the goods, the quality of the drinks, quality of the food, and also, being really genuine with the customers there. And the first year and a half, I shook everyone's hand before they left and thanked them for coming in.
Mm-hmm.
And the only time I stopped doing that was when we got too busy and
yeah.
I couldn't actually go shake hands anymore. And that's something you don't really find nowadays, people that are willing to really give themselves up to the community.
That's right.
And, we led the business heart first, not profit first. And so the community's really supported us. We've grown now into three locations. All three locations are twice as big as our original location.
Oh, yeah.
So, we went from about 1,000 square foot of operating space to about 5,000 square feet of operating space in Hampton Roads. And we're very, very proud, and we're still local, business-oriented. One of my customers said to me the other day, you guys went from a local secret to a local staple, and I thought that was kind of cute.
Oh, that is cool.
I'm going to make it.
Well, now, what got you really interested in coffee?
To be honest, Patrick, it was actually traveling overseas and
yes.
seeing the food culture and the quality of the food culture in another country firsthand, and that really opened up my eyes a lot. America, we mostly eat fast food. We drink soda pops. We need big drinks because we've been told by corporations that we get really crappy food, but they'll give us a 64-ounce soda, and that provides value somehow.
Yeah.
And so I went overseas, and I saw that the rest of the world had a very strict food culture. It had to be healthy. It had to be correct portions. It had to be organic. It had to be local, or else they wouldn't buy it. So it really started to open my mind. I remember even then, I'm talking 15, 16, 17 years ago, taking pictures of dishes I saw in other countries and still remembering those all the way when I had JavaSurf, and that inspiration followed. So, like I already mentioned, real local based, but what that means to us, that community, is what are we really feeding our neighbors? Our customers live next door to us.
And that's a good point, because you're not just coffee. You do have a really great chef-driven menu.
Absolutely.
That kind of encompasses a lot of local food and foodways, and also kind of embraces, as your name does too, kind of our local surfer community too.
Exactly.
Very good. Now, what would you give a tip or two to folks to really just enjoy their cup of coffee, whether they brew it at home or whether they come in here and get it?
Well, if you're making coffee at home, I would start with probably just a little bit more grounds than you might think you need, because
yeah.
everybody's taste preferences are different.
Mm-hmm.
And, just following a recipe on the back of a bag doesn't always work. It's kind of like when you're baking. Sometimes you got to throw in something because it feels right, or sometimes you got to throw in something because you love that extra ingredient.
Yes.
And that's what really makes it perfect. So I would just encourage people to experiment a little bit, try a little bit more water, try a little less water, try grinding the beans different, and trying to see what flavor profile works for you the most, because that's actually going to make you the happiest. A lot of people love French presses. A lot of people love drip coffee. Obviously, I love espresso.
Oh, yeah.
And they're all equal in the sense of what you personally like. I only drink espresso drinks now, but I know everything about coffee because, it's a very, everyone loves it.
Mm-hmm.
And people always find it funny, like, what do you mean you don't drink coffee? You own a coffee shop. Well, that's true, but I drink coffee in the form of espresso. And that's a common misnomer.
Yes.
It's all coffee beans.
Yes.
And a lot of people think espresso is something different. Espresso is a coffee bean that has been roasted with the intention of being used on an espresso machine. That's all it really is. So I'm still drinking coffee just in the form of espresso shots rather than cups of coffee. But
and that is a pretty fancy machine there. What all does it do?
This machine is actually, I love it. I'm a big fan of antiques. Uh-huh. Just like you can see on the back wall, the old Aaliyah surfboards.
That's awesome.
Big fan of antiques and kind of paying homage to what came before us. Mm-hmm. A lot of people, you know, get caught up in the newest surfboard or the newest type of trunks or whatever. But really, you literally can go surf on a plank of wood. You don't have to have the newest, lightest, most, you know, aquadynamic surfboard. And the same thing is in our industry. This particular machine is a reproduction of Astoria's first mass-produced machine. So this is a remake of a 1962 espresso machine, which gives it a more of a unique look. You can buy an espresso machine for your house for probably a grand or two, but for commercial, you're really looking to spend, you know, $10,000 and up on a really nice machine, because this baby has to make about 400 drinks a day.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And that's a heavy load. So, of course, it needs to be a very strong, sturdy, commercial machine to be able to handle that much workload. But I do love this machine. All three of our locations have excellent espresso machines. This one, of course, is my favorite.
Very good. Now, and getting back to brewing at home too, you do sell coffee to take home.
We do.
You know, for folks to brew too.
We do. We brew our own light roast coffee, and then we have a couple proprietary roasts that we do. Like Costa Rica is our house favorite roast. It's our medium light roast, our medium bodied roast, and it's actually fantastic. And we certainly sell more of that than, say, our dark roast. Our dark roast is fantastic as well. Sumatra is what our dark roast is. So
what,
you know,
how are we doing here?
I'm actually just trying to pull some of this crema down into this drink here, and then just lay a little heart there for you on top. But
oh, how cool!
Just a little tiny guy.
Very good.
Espresso shots are a little bit different because you're taking about 16 grams of ground coffee and passing through hot water at a very, very, very high pressure. So in this business, it's called 9 bars of pressure. 9 bars of pressure is stronger than all 4 of your car tires exploding simultaneously.
Oh, wow.
More PSI than all 4 of your car tires. So there's a ton of pressure and heat built up in this.
And I guess if you drink too much espresso, you might feel that way.
You could also.
Well, very good. And so that sounds really cool. And looks like a lot of people are really enjoying a lot of coffee here. And so, Dwayne, I sure do appreciate everything.
There you go, Patrick.
All right.
Just making tickets while we talk.
All right. I'll take one to go. Thank you, Dwayne.
Yeah, Patrick.